report is made in English, Spanish and Danish.
Eso es la versión española. This is the Spanish version. Find the other versions on the channel María María.
Hola, soy tu astróloga María Yelmo, aquí con tu reportaje cuántica y astrológica para abril de 2021. Y aquí estoy en un artículo sobre astrología, una entrevista muy positiva. Es muy bueno ver que Dinamarca también se abre hacia la astrología. Ese herramienta tan preciso y bueno. Ese reportaje es hecho en inglés, danés y español, y eso es la versión española. Y hoy vamos a hablar primeramente sobre lo cuántico. Vamos a empezar con la física cuántica, después vamos a hablar sobre el nodo norte en Géminis y lo de viajar, el nodo sur en Sagitario. Después de eso, el reportaje colectivo y vamos a tomar cada uno de los signos después de eso, con cartas de tarot. Vamos a terminar con una meditación, ¿por qué? Tu punto de atracción, según la ley de la atracción, empieza con tu capacidad de recibir, y la meditación es necesario practicar cada día para mantener ese punto de recibir en tu zona de vibración personal. Bueno, vamos a empezar. La ley de la atracción trata de que lo que transmites tú es lo que atraes también. Quiero decir que lo más importante es tu punto de enfoque, porque tu punto de enfoque va a determinar tu vibración, y tu vibración es el canal en la que atraes. Así que si tienes un problema y enfoques en el problema, siempre vas a atraer la misma energía que el problema. Si quieres encontrar una solución, tienes que enfocar en la solución, por supuesto. No en la cómo, sino que en el por qué. ¿Por qué quieres esa transformación? ¿Por qué quieres eso y eso? Oh, porque se siente tan bien. Tu vibración va a cambiarse desde el punto de atracción, que era el problema, hasta una solución. Y no es tu trabajo saber el cómo. La ley de la atracción y la naturaleza va a asegurarse naturalmente que según tu vibración, una respuesta va a venir a tu puerta en un tiempo divino. Significa que si pongas o si pones presión o de alguna manera en que ahora quiero eso, tienes que dármelo, tienes que hacerlo, ahora quiero ver cómo lo hago. Esa energía solamente cree más resistencia y no la solución. Tienes que dejarlo y enfocar en la energía de recibir. Así que intuicionalmente, por tu intuición, puedes podrás recibir la inspiración que va a traerte al fin o a la solución o al sueño que tienes. Se trata de navegar sin remar. Se trata de navegar con confianza en el flujo. ¿Cómo se llama? Se trata de tener confianza en el corriente del río. sin remar. ¿Cómo se siente navegar sin remar? Se siente bien, ¿no? Se trata de tener confianza en que tienes un ser superior que siempre te atrae hacia exactamente lo que es tu paso siguiente. Si tienes problemas con mi manera de pronunciar, hay otras astrólogas que puedes ver también. Probablemente no con el mismo perspectivo como yo. Pero como soy danesa, no es tan fácil hablar español en el mismo nivel que tú. Hablo 6 idiomas, 3 idiomas mejor que los otros 3 idiomas. Y el idioma 7 es la astrología, un idioma en sí mismo. Y si tienes ese interés, va a poder ayudarte mucho con entender tu plan de tu vida, como cuando empiezas en la escuela, vas a recibir un plan para lunes, para martes, miércoles, jueves, etc. Eso es un plan muy profundo, con muchos niveles, que va a describir el por qué eso es difícil y qué puedes aprender y por qué eso es fácil y cómo puedes manejar dentro de ese tipo de energía, etc. Es una buena herramienta o herramienta, no lo sé, para navegar en la vida. Sí, bueno, vamos a empezar o seguir. Durante esa luna nueva en Aries, empezamos de nuevo. Llevo ese traje de Rainbowland, es mi diseño de jumpsuit. Y ahora con rebaja, cuesta 600 coronas. Y puedes ver cuánto eso es en tu... no sé qué valor tu moneda tiene. Bueno, y aquí en el fondo vas a poder ver la playa que está unos 800 metros desde aquí, donde camino con Happy, o caminé con Happy ayer durante la noche con una vista bastante bonita en el fondo. Bueno, durante esa luna... luna nueva en Aries, empezamos de nuevo y tenemos la luna, el sol y Venus en 22 grados de Aries. Tenemos el regente de Aries en Géminis, en 23 grados de Géminis, en sextil actualmente, y también en recepción mutual tenemos en su signo, en el signo de Marte, el regente de Gemini, Mercurio, en conjunción con Quirón. Y aquellos dos son o están en sextil con Saturno en Acuario, mientras Júpiter está en sextil con Venus, el Sol y la Luna en Aries, y en Trine con Marte en Géminis. Plutón está en cuadratura con Venus, el Sol y la Luna en Aries, y eso significa que hay una mezcla, y Saturno actualmente en cuadratura con Urano en Tauro todavía. Eso significa que pasan muchas cosas durante esa luna nueva. Cada vez que tenemos una luna nueva en un signo, es el principio de los próximos 6 meses hasta la luna llena en el mismo signo. Y así que eso es para el primer signo de Aries, significa que actualmente esa luna nueva va a estar para el próximo año, para 12 meses. Y es el nuevo yo. Y es el yo futuro de nosotros que ya ha entrado en nuestras vidas. Y con Júpiter
en esa posición es el, la visión del futuro yo de manera más positiva que puedes imaginar. Y con Marte allá en Géminis, en el signo del dualismo, ahora mismo probablemente hay dos oportunidades, dos elecciones, dos personas, dos algo que puedes, entre los dos puedes elegir o puedes recibir ayuda desde dos lados o qué sé yo. Todo eso pasa en signos de aire y fuego, y eso significa que hay una energía muy rápida ahora mismo, que las cosas pueden cambiar de manera rápida. Una idea puede entrar en tu cabeza de manera rápida y tienes que escribirlo y actuar de manera rápida, tal vez también. Tenemos que saber que esa energía de rapidez cambiará con Marte, que entra en Cáncer el 23 de abril, y eso significa que hasta el 23 de abril, si tienes algunos proyectos que quieres terminar, empezar o qué sé yo, tienes que hacerlo ahora. Tenemos unos 11 o 12 días, dependiendo de cuando vas a ver eso, para hacer las cosas que necesita tu energía y tu cuerpo, porque Marte también es tu cuerpo, y en Cáncer no puede usar su energía de manera normal, tiene más que ver con sentimientos y con apoyar su niño interior y con, ¿cómo se llama?, relajarse y sentir y, bueno, esas cosas. Venus cambiará así, o el 14 de abril, o el 15, o 14. Y eso significa que después de empezar las nuevas cosas, vamos a recibir inspiración para relajarnos en nuestras relaciones y para crear las nuevas ideas de una manera tranquila, más tranquila. Y Saturno en buen aspecto con Mercurio en Quirón, y Quirón entre Aries y Acuario, significa que Quirón, que es el sentido de, Quirón en Aries es el sentido de impotencia, no es solamente corporal, pero el sentido de no sentirse valiente, o no sentir que uno tiene valor bastante grande para poder actualizar nuestros sueños, no tener valor bastante grande para sentirse bastante bien para recibir amor o qué sé yo. Pero con Mercurio en conjunción con Quirón vamos a intentar algunas cosas, y con buen aspecto con el futuro Acuario y Saturno vamos a poder poner algunos marcos y estabilidad alrededor de nuestro ser nuevo y las acciones y decisiones que tomamos ahora mismo vas a poder tener confianza en que son correctas. Por ese Saturno, Saturno va a asegurar que tomas las decisiones mejores para tu futuro, Acuario. Marte, por supuesto, está en cuadratura, era en cuadratura desde el 9 de abril hasta el, no más que el 9, el 3, actualmente era exacto el 9 de abril y empezó el 13 el 3 de abril y vas a terminar el 15 de abril esa cuadratura entre Marte y Neptuno en Piscis. Eso puede traer consigo confusión, porque es Neptuno. Neptuno y Marte eran juntos en junio 2020. En junio 2020 recibiste alguna idea de un sueño, tu sueño, solamente una idea. ¿Entendiste tu sueño? ¿Qué era? ¿O qué es? Y ahora, Marte se ha movido tres signos y está en cuadratura, significa que ahora Marte va a quitar el pasado y las ilusiones del pasado, que, porque ahora Marte quiere lograr su sueño, lograr concebir su sueño. Y por eso Marte tiene que dejar las ilusiones que ya no sirve en ese marco que está su sueño. Eso era un poco, ¿cómo puedo decirlo? Bueno, todas las ilusiones que no va a servir el sueño van a desaparecer. Eso es lo que quiere Marte ahora. Después del 15 de abril, la confusión va a irse. Ojalá. ¿Qué más? ¡Bah! Plutón, en cuadratura con Venus, el Sol y la Luna. Por supuesto, Plutón en esa cuadratura significa que el miedo que antes tenías, el miedo de que no puedes lograr ese sueño de ser quien eres y gozar la vida como quien eres, porque no era posible hace un año o qué sé yo, o más durante toda su vida, tal vez. Ese es miedo de que el pasado va a repetirse. Plutón va a crear un texto que está seguro que tienes ese nuevo ser. Vamos a ver si es tan fijo en ti. Vamos a ver si puedes actualmente vivir ese nuevo ser. Y es cuando tienes temor, tendrás temor, recuerda esa palabra, fe. Tienes que tener fe que eso es un nuevo paso hacia el futuro. Un nuevo futuro que ya está creándose. sí. ¿Qué más? Si quieres verlo de manera más clara, eso es... Bueno, Aries es el chakra del raíz. Algo está transformado en tu zona de vibración que tiene que ver con la conexión con la tierra. Y por eso, ¿cuánto confianza tienes cuando estás en tu mismo cuerpo? Tiene que ver con tener coraje. Aries es coraje. Coraje para ser quien eres. ¿Qué más? Bueno, el 15, el Sol está en cuadratura con Plutón. Algo va a caer, algo kármico que ha estado en tu vida durante mucho tiempo va a desaparecer. Hay ese sentido en el centro de abril de que puedes sentir que por fin pasa algo. Por fin eso va a pasar. Aries es el nuevo comienzo, el primer signo. Y normalmente vemos el Aries como un animal un poco agresivo y egoísta. Pero también no solamente es el... Es eso, también es el
lo nuevo, ¿no? Lo naivo, lo auténtico, lo... el potencial más grande, lo puro, con amor. En Aries también tenemos mucho amor, es para la vida, amor para todo, amor y alegría, potencial enorme. Porque Aries solamente es agresivo cuando está suprimido, cuando su energía tal vez primitiva o energía ingenua es Aries. Y también instintivo, es al suprimir esa energía, la agresión vendrá. Por eso tenemos que aprender también, según la ley de la atracción, ser auténticos. Porque si no eres auténtico, no hablas la verdad a tú mismo. Si no sabes qué es tu verdad, tú mismo, ¿verdad? ¿Cómo puedes atraer lo que quieres si solamente quieres algo que los demás dicen que tienes que querer? Oh, solamente vas a tener felicidad si tienes un coche grande, si tienes una novia o un novio que parece así o qué sé yo. Tienes que ser auténtico. Y por eso, porque atraemos desde la vibración que tenemos. Y al querer atraer tu potencial más alto, tienes que vibrar desde tu punto de vibración más alto. Y eso se puedes hacer si haces meditación cada día de alguna manera donde encuentras el silencio, y tienes que cada día, como lo más importante en tu vida, tener enfoque en que lo más importante es que te sientes bien, porque al sentirte bien puedes recibir y eres en contacto con tu ser superior cada vez que te sientes bien. Si no sientes bien, has perdido el contacto con tu centro y con tu ser superior. Y desde ese punto no sabes si atraes lo más importante para ti. Y tienes también que saber que si ahora mismo has perdido amigos, un novio, una novia, o un trabajo, una amistad, o como, qué sé yo, todo lo que no está en tu vida ahora mismo, tuve que desaparecer por tu potencial máximo y por el potencial máximo de la persona que se fue. Hay mucha gente que ahora despierta a la realidad ahora mismo, que ahora hay mucha más gente que entiende que no podemos ver la televisión, las medias, la media en general como autoridades, porque está creado según la realidad de alguna gente solamente, como tú creas tu realidad. Así que tienes que saber que creas y formas tu misma realidad, y eso lo haces por tu enfoque. Y ese reportaje te ayuda a demostrar el punto de enfoque de la naturaleza, porque tenemos ciclos en la naturaleza, y si seguimos esos ciclos podemos obtener lo más... Si seguimos el ciclo de la naturaleza podemos
recibir el potencial más grande o máximo de la energía, porque según tu enfoque atraes, pero si la naturaleza también enfoque en la misma dirección como tú, el punto de atracción va a estar mucho más fuerte. Y por eso es una buena idea combinar la ley de la atracción con la astrología. Y todo es energía y por eso funciona la astrología. Porque hay una energía en cada planeta, en la Tierra, en el Sol, en la Luna, en yo, en tú. Todos somos energías. Y podemos cambiar el punto de atracción siempre por tu enfoque. Sí, pero la realidad es así. Sí, pero si enfocas en la realidad como es y la realidad no es lo que quieres, tienes que enfocar en otra cosa. Sí, pero la realidad es así. Sí, pero adentro de ti puedes crear la nueva realidad según tu vibración. Por visitar a tu interior cada día por meditación o otras cosas que te pongas pones en contacto con el lugar donde actualmente puedes cambiar tu punto de enfoque. Algo que crees es solamente porque has pensado el mismo pensamiento muchas veces. Si cambias ese pensamiento a otro pensamiento, tu realidad y tu fe va a cambiarse también y puedes crear qué es. Si piensas que no tienes bastante valor para recibir amor, adivinas qué va a pasar. Si actualmente crees que para ti alguien como tú, tan agradable, tan amable, en esa vida hay tanto amor, cariñosidad, abundancia de alegría y felicidad. Y si sientes cómo se siente actualmente sentir que tienes ese valor y que eso es posible, cómo se siente, cómo se siente estar valiente para todo lo que quieres. Se dicen que deseos son malos para la espiritualidad, pero todos somos nacidos, estamos nacidos con deseos desde nuestras almas que queremos lograr en esa vida, durante esa vida, en un nivel del alma. Y por supuesto, hay la posibilidad de tener una vida en alegría y amor. Si puedes imaginarlo y pensarlo, es posible. Y yo puedo imaginar una vida con felicidad y alegría y amor. ¿Puedes? ¿Tú? Bueno, vamos a seguir con cada uno de los signos. En inglés, voy a tomar cartas de tarot y también hablar un poco de cada signo. Tu ascendente, lugar de tu sol o tu luna. Eso es lo que voy a describir. Vamos a terminar con una meditación que puedes encontrar dentro de los últimos 20 hasta 30 minutos. Un enlace, no sé dónde, que puedes presionar y va a traerte hacia la meditación. Subimos en tu signo. Recuerdas que hay un nuevo yo que ahora has nacido y se trata de ti, se trata de tus sueños, se trata de tu nuevo yo y se trata de que cuando tu viejo yo dice, ah, que no puedes, que vas a decir, cállate. Que ahora se trata de lo bueno que estoy creando. Ahora voy a estar la visión que siempre he tenido con mi mejor imagen del yo que soy. Ten confianza en el proceso. Sea auténtica o auténtico y sigue tu corazón. Congratulations, Aries. Aries. So for you guys, of course, it's the new beginning of who you are. Is that new you? That new you that's just like communicating clearly, directly, with love, with kindness, with authenticity. Ready to manifest your dreams. You're settled up and you are on your way. You already started something and now you're ready to move forward and no one's gonna be able to hit you because you are ready to manifest an earthly life of your dreams. You juggle with several things right now, Aries, two options, two people, two things, two projects, two dreams. You can manage it. That's support. We have your ruler and mutual reception with Mercury, that dualistic communicator. Go for it. Whatever idea you have and what you've planned for, you just go for it. It's valid and it is what you want and what you need. You just continue trusting in that that's going to fulfill and be fulfilled and unfold for you. Notice the signs along the way and take inspired action because you're always guided. So you don't need to plan ahead and you don't need to force anything through. Just act when you can feel that it's right to act. Trust the process. Astrology cards. Libra, eye balance. Just find that balance between you and in your relationships. Remember that each time you move forward, a rest is needed. Maybe you can feel now that the time when we reach Cancer and on the 23rd of April will be good for you. You will be able to find that balance by getting some well-deserved rest. And just remember to sleep as much as you are active. No, not as much, but you know, get that introverted time as well as the outroverted. Just find that balance. And abundance will come to you. It's in your 11th house of spiritual abundance. Visions for the future. Jupiter will just stay positive and optimistic because there's good reason for being it. Last card for you, Aries, the energy card. Feeling good will bring me far more than whatever I thought I needed. So feeling good is your goal, your main goal. And then all the rest will follow. Your job is just to feel good. That will bring you in the receptive mode and nature will be able to, through law of attraction, to attract to you the things that your higher self will want. So just make sure that you are in balance and feel good, Aries. Taurus. So Taurus, this is in your 12th house where you are letting go of things and sometimes it can feel like you need to cut a lot of cords and make clarity for yourself and you will get that clarity because your planet is in conjunction with the sun and the moon. So you are, and we have Mercury in the same sign on top of Chiron. So you are now getting more and more clear about what your values are and you're starting on a fresh with what your higher spiritual values are and your potential, how big it actually is, your potential. And also subconscious things, you're cutting the cord to subconscious things that came up in the form of what seemed like enemies or, you know, hidden enemies or whatever. But there's a good thing going on in within your career right now, and you're receiving intuition. And okay, of course, it feels like you have fought some battles where maybe you were the winner, but it also feels like maybe you lost your friends, some friends, in that battle. But you lose some, you win some. For some reason, there's a need to keep something quiet or just do something unnoticed if it's not a karmically bad thing to do. If it feels motivated to do something that no one is to find out about, but it feels right still to do it, I don't know what it is. It's just that this card indicates that, or maybe it's just someone else playing a trick on you, getting away with it. The feeling of that someone played your trick and got away with it. And it doesn't matter. Get over it and focus upon what you're good at. Focus upon what you're good at and share it with others, because you have so much abundance within you in your energy field and also in your potential that you can share with others what you're good at. Share with others what you know how to do. And there's a lot happening. You're transforming your views on the world, in the world. And of course, it's like there's something you're a little bit stubborn about that it's hard for you to transform. And maybe marriage is close by. Are you getting married? Did you find a soulmate? Are you just really fond of who you're with? Or is it just that your inner masculine and feminine is finally equally balanced? Could it be that? Because your ruler is in the sign of, it's actually in perfect aspect to Mars, so it's your feminine and masculine. I mean, finally they're walking along on the same path, so it feels like there's some inner agreement upon where to go. You still need to cleanse and detoxify, of course, because the new moon is in your 12th house, where we need to surrender, trusting the process, even though it can feel hard. Until your birthday. Destiny. You're on the path to your destiny. Trust that there's a divine timing to everything. Have faith. And in your ninth house, we have Pluto. You're being transformed, and you are getting a better understanding of it, that you are the creator of your reality and that power you have if you connect to the highest good or to the source in whatever it is that you do. And then, shock of the new. Okay, so the Uranus is in your sign, so in square to Saturn, so maybe it's just like, oh, you really have to get used to that the situations are changing so rapidly, and how to deal with it. Don't be afraid of being lonely. You will never be. We are all connected, and there's always love for the one who tune into love. That's what the law of attraction will always make sure of. And this card says, I slow down and listen to the guidance that's available to me. If you ever get in doubt or fear, then give yourself some quiet time. Slow down and receive the guidance that's there for you. Just wait until it comes. Or don't wait. Just, you know, focus upon relaxing. Oh, meditating. And then the inspiration will come from within. You will just know. Gemini, this is in your 11th house of friendships, and you have a mutual reception between your ruler and you have Mars in your first house. Some justice is being made. Something that you did a long time ago that wasn't fair is going to be equilibrated. It's going to find an equilibrium. Somehow there's a balance found, and it's not just something that happened the last month. It's a balance that you needed for a long time. That's and a justice happening. Someone is, or something is coming to you that's it's fair. Something unjust might have happened, and now you feel that this justice coming your way, and you understand why. You just need to be a little bit better at receiving. Do you remember to meditate and stay open to what's the guidance that comes to you? Because this card indicates with the closed arms that something is being given that you don't receive. remember to do so. And then once you do, apparently, someone is going to give you something, or you're going to be the giver of something charitable to someone else. Your 11th house and your 9th house is activated, so there's definitely a good opening of your view on the world is going to be widened. If you focus upon service and joyfully serve, then some purpose will then serve you, because there's this stream then of giving and receiving that will just, you will get into that mode where whatever it is that you want to attract in your life, if you don't focus so much upon exactly what it is you're going to attract, but just more to serve in general, then you will have your vibrational field opened towards nature being able to work through you with whatever you need. Then you will be served as well, and you will just have to trust your intuition and listen to it, as I said with that guy being given a cup. Grantine blessings, definitely, yes. Mars in your sign, in trine to Jupiter in your 9th house. So first the 9th house activated with a grand trine. Well, we don't have anything over there in Libra, but whenever there's an indication of a trine and the two spots are being represented and the last spot is not, then we always go to the last spot and say, okay, that's where you need to put some extra focus, and that's in Libra in your 5th house. So make sure that you make time for your hobbies, for romantic things, for your children, for creativity, for music, for playing, for, you know, just having fun, hanging around other people that you like hanging around, that gives you joy, and harmonize, balance things, be diplomatic when diplomacy is needed, and take good care of your body. But that's going to be easy for you now, getting some exercise and good sleep and everything, you know, good nutrition and everything. So what do you feel? What do you feel? One of your best resources is your intuition, Gemini. Do you remember to use it? And what do you feel like? What do you want? What is your dream? What is it that you dream about? It's time to go for it. Ooh, my little dog, Happy, who's a Gemini, is seeing something outside the door. I'm gonna pick him up in a second. Last card for you guys. When I'm connected to the spirit, I feel a sense of certainty, magnitude, and ease that I've never known before. So it is about connecting to your intuition and your higher self and to spirit, which just means that you turn your eyes inward and feel. Oh, so nice to feel into things. And then you let go and surrender through meditation. And there you find that feeling of, yeah, it's all just like it's supposed to be, and it's so grand, our potential here, and it's so easy. And that sense is the feeling that will be very good for you to just keep going back to focus upon, focus upon, focus upon. Then the law of attraction will do the rest. Cancer, 10th house of career activated along with your 12th and your 8th house. So the first card I draw is a romantic sense of caring, loving feelings. So we have the moon with Venus, of course, so that's going to give you like this loving expression, and someone is going to show appreciation of you and give you love and care, and you will do the same. Then we have this one upside down. This means that there is an ending, that you have a little bit hard time. This is actually an ending. It's like a mental ending of thinking in a certain pattern that you should be over with now. And the light is now showing itself in the background, but it was upside down. So is there a mental process that you keep on holding on to too tight? There's something, a way of thinking that you might now really take this opportunity as this new moon to stop that. Just stop that. You know it's not good for you. Because now it's fire is on for new projects, new beginnings, new entrepreneurial, passionate endeavors that you have waited for a long time has now got the Ace of Wands, which is fire in the new direction. Yes, so go for that career adventure of yours. New partner, new business partner, new marital partner, new some kind of connection you have with someone else is showing up for this business endeavor. Or what? Maybe it's not a business endeavor, maybe it's just a creative project, maybe, but it's just something about you, something that's important to you. Shower of abundance, there's help, there's everything you need for that project. Go for it. Stop doubting. Trust your intuition, it's hella good. Third house messages. There is a need for you to communicate clearly. Your third house is in Virgo, and that's with details. So just be open, communicate, get things going through communication. Share your idea, be receptive to other people's ideas about it. Going beyond normal, think outside the box of what you usually think of. Relax and the hold of darkness and be at course. Just serve. And then just serve some purpose, and then the purpose will serve you. Whenever you feel like, oh, I don't know what to do now, then just serve, and then whatever you want have to do now will come to you, or be given to you. I release time and let the universe show me what to do. Good idea. You don't force anything, you let it come in the right time. Leo. Woo, Leo, it's in your ninth house. So friendships, good times with other people is around the corner for you. Enjoy, make sure to enjoy life with others. Just be social and let that kind of feeling come forth. It's a good place. It's between your ninth, your 11th, and your 7th house of relationships. So there's good energies and vibes going on here. Just as long as you don't let yourself be torn down by some kind of daily routine that you don't need to practice anymore. Trust that you're going into a new state of life, even though you don't know what's bringing, what's there for you. Trust that it's good. It feels for you like a tower is falling because you're losing something and you can't do anything about it. Well, when the tower card is there, it's because it's due time. This has been due time for a long time. So what's falling away is so good for you because it is not serving you to be there with those people, with that person anymore. So even though it feels like the carpet has been pulled under you, it was right for it to be so. Got the same card again. Just move with full of faith into that new transformational state of your life, Leo. And acceptance, again, acceptance is a little bit like the Tower card. Accept whatever's going on in your life and you will see, wow, good things will come with it. Cupid, just send everything in your life love. Be in that state of love, be love. That's your job. And you do that by just doing whatever makes you happy and joyful. That's gonna bring you love. Sixth house of routine. Pluto is activated in your sixth house. So yeah, there's some job you need to do. That also, so not only good times with friends, also some work that needs to be done. What do you feel? Follow your intuition. Follow your feelings. If they are out of balance, find them. It's priority one. Find the balance and the good feeling again and be guided from there. Spirals of manifestation is coming from you fast, very fast. So make sure that the vibration you send out is the right vibration. Whatever you focus, there's no assertion, there's no anti. So whatever you focus upon, if you have a war against something, whatever you're against will be strengthened in your life. If you have a pro war for, yeah, this is what I want, then it's not a war, then it's just joy that will come to you. So focus upon what you want, not what you don't want. Virgo. Do you feel sometimes like you're waking up with some kind of a nightmare? Oh, but there are roses on your bed. It's a good, even though you feel like a war has been going on and in your mind, but then it was all in your mind. Just see that whatever war was going on, it was in your mind. You change it by stopping your thoughts. When you have no thoughts, you have no resistance. And you can end that old story for the big, new, bold and amazing, brave story of yours to come forth. This is such a strong, powerful card. It's in your eighth house, this new moon. So it's a big transformation of things that was hard for you to transform. Some death of something in your life that's no longer going to be with you. Something is over because something new has to come in. This was even better. You can feel a little overburdened that there's a lot to do. And also, yeah, you have many balls in the air. Mutual reception between your planet and Mars and Gemini, so a lot is going on, so just make sure you get some rest. And again, that mental thing, get out of your head and stop telling a story that's not serving you. I think you're good at it, at telling the new story, even though you feel like maybe you're not worth it, maybe you're not good enough. You are. Just stop the mental things, get some fresh air, go out and walk instead. Whenever you feel like, oh, now it's coming, go out and walk in nature or wherever you can walk and just be. Feel your feet touch the ground, breathing. Let your past go. Just let it go. Stop telling the old story. Have some fun. It's Aries season. You want to be like the lamb, having fun, enjoying. Moon, your soul, moon in Aries. Just feel. Feel more into your life. It's time for you to feel life. So much more than this to think life, even though you like that, then you're also good at feeling life. Go with your intuition, feeling, go inside your body, meditate, always focus on the light. My greatest spiritual shifts don't come through force, they come through freedom. Don't force anything through. Just let whatever is be in acceptance, and then see that as you set anyone and anything free in your life, you will receive some great spiritual gifts. Libra. Woo, it's in your seventh house. Someone is gonna celebrate you, Libra, because you are so beautiful and wonderful. And you're just gonna be like, yay, she's home. It's between your fifth, seventh, and ninth house. It's just like romance, joy, hobbies, fun. Of course, also maybe a little conflict at home in your home life, but not so much as all your fun with your children, hobbies, projects, singing, dancing, being creative, meeting other people, expanding your mind and your visions. Oops, cutting some cords. Also to something mental that is not serving you, and be a little bit selfish and navel. Look at your own navel and just enjoy how amazing you are. So it's about a little selfishness, Libra. Just loving yourself is good for you. It's good for you this Aries season. Focus upon you, you, you. Perfect timing for something, a project or something in your life has perfect timing. Don't know what it is. Daydream and you will be, or meditate, and you will be receiving inspiration to when you need to act. Otherwise, just focus upon feeling good. Third house messages. Be open to receive that intuition. There's some messages coming through to you. Mercury is in the same sign as your planet now. But more so the moon is on with you, with Venus, your ruler. There's something coming through to you intuitionally now. Be sure to receive that. Appreciation dissolves all blocks to the presence of my super attractor power. So appreciating whatever is in your life, just being so happy for what you have been given, will dissolve any blocks that make you the master manifester that you are. Just be in a state of appreciation, then everything will go well. Scorpio. Oh, you also feel like you're waking up with some kind of nightmare. What was it that you went through? This is in your sixth, between your sixth, sorry, the sixth, eighth, fourth, sixth, and eighth house. So you went through something that wasn't that much fun. And now you're waking up and just need to see that it was also all in your head. So it's always about remembering that your thoughts are your worst blocks. If you want to remove any blocks to your power manifesting pause. You need to stop thinking too much and just enjoy nature, enjoy what you've already manifested for yourself, appreciate yourself and what you've come to fruition, enjoy some alone time with yourself where you just enjoy being you. Stop thinking, and whatever keeps you trapped in the same routine of thinking, oh, I need this to be happy. No, it's in your head. It's all in your mind. Whatever feels bad right now, it's in your mind. You attract it through focusing on it, upon it. Just live your daily life and start appreciating what's all around you through your day-to-day life. And justice will be served and a balance will be found automatically. You don't have to do anything but focusing upon feeling good. Then you will see that nature will make sure that that balance will be refound. Your life purpose will be more and more clear, and you are really on the path of unfolding your life's purpose right now. Energy work is being done. This new moon is starting out some body work, some get your rest. Make sure to get enough rest, eat properly. Rest is maybe one of the most important, to not stress, and that you do by getting enough rest, enough meditation. So enough good spiritual food, good psychological food, good physical food is important right now for the Scorpios. Nurture yourself. Eighth house ending and endings and beginnings. Your ruler is in the eighth house. A lot of things are ending right now so that something new, your dream, can begin. Chiron, you're also healing something. So if something has been feeling a little tight, it's because there's a healing process going on. But just remember to trust that you are freaking amazing and you're valuable to receive that dream and now and make that dream of yours fulfilled. What is already with you? Actually, what it is that you think you're about to manifest is already been manifested. It's not about that you have to create it now, it's allowing it in. Go into the receptive mode. What it is that you want is ready for you, but it can't get into the door when the door is closed. So you just need to be in the receptive mode and everything you want will come. I can do less and attract more. You don't need to do as much as you think you need to do. Be a powerful attractor through going into the receptive mode and finding that feminine yin energy. It'll be even easier for you from the 23rd as your ruler moves into your ninth house. Sagittarius. Woo! Two cards. Justice will be served. It's in your fifth house. There's some kind of justice. It's between your third, fifth, and your seventh house. This new moon, everything that I mentioned in the collective report. So some kind of justice will be made, so you'll find more balance in your life. And be in a process of just working step by step, step by step. Uranus in your sixth house is just gonna, you know, if you work and enjoy your work, just be in a good, I mean, be less focused upon the result than the actual work itself and the loving of the little things you do. And some kind of battle you have won over someone, mental battle perhaps, something where you were right, but you also might have lost a friend, or it wasn't as fun to win as you thought it would be, and there's a lesson there. Soon a new life will start. The judgment card is here. This means that you're really wrapping up something for something new to begin. And you ride forward with much more clarity. This new moon is going to bring you some kind of clarity so that you can be welcomed home at last. Someone is waiting for you. Make sure you find balance between giving and receiving so that you get enough rest as well as, you know, make sure that you get enough rest, but also exercise. I feel my way into faith one step at a time. So it's also about just being in the moment, not forcing anything through. Take the next logical step, not rationally logical, but next intuitively logical step, and the next, not jump too far ahead, even though that's something that you also like to do. Aries, I am. It's all about you just enjoying who you are and going out there and find a little romance or creativity to do in your life. going beyond normal. Think outside the box and allow that
just your authentic self to shine through enormously. Capricorn. Time for you guys. Bam, bam. So, Capricorn, this is in your fourth house, between your second, fourth, and your sixth house. And it's a fire sign, and we have a fire card now with five people showing a little bit off in a so-called fight, but it's more for show off than it is an actual fight. So maybe you're out there stretching your stuff and showing what you're made of, and that you have what it takes. Yeah, definitely so, because you're really sharing your what it is that you're good at what you came into this life mastering. Now you're giving, passing it on to other people. Someone is welcoming you home. You're gonna feel like you come home and that you are loved in the home that you have. The people you live with really love you and value you and appreciate that you are who you are and know that you have great value to these people in your life. And life purpose, you're on the path of your life purpose, so don't doubt that you're on the wrong path. You're always on the right path. There's a divine timing, so wherever you are is the right path. There's no need to question that, and you're definitely extra fulfilling it right now somehow. Oops. I want to take these cards first. Faith in the process. Always trust the process. We know that one, but it's sometimes you have Pluto in your life, so you're still in your first house, so you're still being transformed immensely. And your own ruler is in your third house, the second house of values and money and self-worth. Fire element, desire. You really want to expand your home, maybe, because it's in your fourth house. You want to redecorate your room, your home. You want to do something new in your home, your home situation. Maybe you're working upon getting pregnant, getting married, or adopting, or getting a new dog or cat, or just fixing the house and making it nice. 10th house, the world. Of course, you're always a little focused upon your career and how your appearance is in the world. Directing my focus onto what's thriving creates more of what I want. So your focus needs just to be whatever makes you happy, on whatever makes you happy, not on anything else, because that's how you get more of what you want, not by focusing on any problem trying to solve it. The universe is going to do that and give you inspired action to how to solve the other things as you just focus upon what makes you happy. Aquarius. Okay, Aquarius, it's in the second house. It's between your 12th, second, and no. Yeah, between your 12th, second, and your third house of communication. The judgment card is meaning that a cycle is ending and a new cycle is beginning. And that you're ready for this, and this will definitely close something up or finish up something that you have been needing to finish up for a long time, so that you get more in balance with your emotions and your feelings. There's a feeling of really being in harmony with your feelings, and that is what you've needed for a long time, and you're mastering your feelings somehow by accepting them and being in them and being in a flow. This is something that this new moon will give you. Whoa, three cards falling out. That sums it all up pretty well. So a broken heart, you had a broken heart somehow, and it's being healed by friends and some new love. Three swords, three cups, and this came first, then this. And then this. So there's a fresh start, a new beginning. Forget that old story about the broken heart. Start telling the new story about the friendships and the good things that are in your life, so that you can attract more of them. And then listen to your intuition and what you feel. It's guiding you all the time. Cleanse and detoxify your mind and your brain. There's a need for that. And after that, you'll be able to really get something solid, grounded in your life. But you really need to take responsibility for what's going on in your mind so that you receive more from your feelings than from mental patterns. Be more aware of your patterns and choose the focal points that make you feel good, the good focal points. Each time I choose to tune into spirit, the guidance of the highest truth shows up for me. So you really need to log on, meditate, get your meditation done, and log on to the eternal net.
if you want to have your real, the best path for you revealed. Hi Pisces, now it's your turn. Now Happy came in. The little mouse. The little dog furry mouse. Ooh, Pisces. This is in your second house. Second house. This new moon in your second and your 12th and in your fourth house. And apparently you are expecting another attack somehow because it feels like you are on the fence in some way. So you're afraid another attack is going to come. But if you just focus upon the good romantic things in your life, that's good. That serves you well, then they will also come. What else, Pisces? Enjoy your daily life so that you focus upon the good things in your day-to-day life. Don't focus upon that you're afraid of another attack because then it will just come. Just expect the good things, even though there's not so much proof for it. Sometimes it's, I mean, to change our reality, we need to focus upon not what is, but what we want it to be by starting to create it on the inside. That's why your fourth house is activated, which is your root, your core, your inner child that needs some kind of service. So you change your focus on just serving a purpose that makes you feel good, serving something that makes you feel good, and then the purpose will serve you somehow. And joy will be the key. If it feels good, if it feels joyful, you're on the right path. If not, change the direction, change the focus. And assertiveness will come. It's in your second house. It's a self-worth. Self-worth is coming your way. Definitely. So self-worth is coming your way. So follow your own rhythm. You need to really, in the fourth house also, and the second house of values, it's like follow your rhythm. Go into your flow and accept the cycles. When you're tired, rest. When you feel energized, okay, then it's time to do something energetic. Every journey starts with a single step. Take one step at a time. Follow the next logical step and the next logical step. Don't jump too far ahead too fast. 10th house of the world. Okay, so now we have apparently Sag. Why Sag activated? Maybe it's just because for you somehow now it's important. Your reputation is somehow important. And how your image is in the world. And the image in your image in the world is how you perceive yourself. So if you work on that and just like trust who you are is amazing and you are worth your dreams. I let the universe catch up with my dreams. Then you make the universe give you inspired action to the next step and the next step. And don't jump too far ahead. Just trust, 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 trust the process. Always. La meditación es en español esta vez. Esta vez he puesto la meditación en un video para sí misma. Siga el enlace en el texto a continuación. O el enlace que aparece en la pantalla en la esquina superior, aquí al final de este vídeo. La meditación es quizás el elemento más importante en el proceso de la ley de atracción. Nos vemos en el segundo vídeo. Y recuerda, la meditación es en español esta vez. Es para que puedas escucharla cada día sin tener que ver el reportaje también. There is this angel saying, I'm gonna find my way back home. The secret is love, he said. You got to lift yourself up, try again. One day you will break through. What you love for Don't follow trends, follow your heart.